Hey everyone, Senor Spot of Nerd here. Ecstatic, excited, kind of pissed off if you've seen the picture I posted up on Facebook or my Instagram. Fuck UPS. But the reason I'm excited is because I want to do a little bit of an unboxing. For those of you that don't know, there's a Walmart exclusive for the original Ghostbusters figures that first came out way back in the early 1990s or something like that. Hasbro has remade these toys from Kenner. Obviously, Kenner doesn't make them, Hasbro makes them, blah, blah, blah. I was looking them up online. I mean, let's be real, I don't toy hunt anymore. That was a thing of the early 2000s, which was exciting and fun. I just think now, with everything we have online, why not just order it online? Yeah, you're gonna pay a little extra, but whatever. Without further ado, let's take a look at the awesome. First up, Mr. Winston Zettermore. I always forget his last name. Look how cool these things are. Look at it. I mean, seriously, look how ridiculously awesome these things are. Does that not take you back to your childhood? Look at that thing. I mean, it's got the Proton pack with the little thing you twist to make the little thingy go, and then you've got a ghost and you've got his back. I'm reliving my childhood. Look at those details. Okay, these are not exactly like toys that are gonna be incredibly detailed and blah blah blah, but they're literally replicas of what I had as a kid, and that's what makes me so excited. Take a look at Peter. It's just, I love these things. Look at these, like the old school, the brown uniform. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you missed out on childhood, because the real Ghostbusters was one of the most amazing cartoons that ever existed. Probably my favorite. And these toys, probably what I first started with. You can't forget Egon. This is where I would throw a middle finger up to UPS, because unfortunately, if you saw the picture of the box, his corner here, I don't know how well you can see that in the camera. Yeah, the corner got kind of jacked up. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but I was like, if you look at the rest of these, like the figures in terms of the condition, they are literally spotless. And that's what makes me so mad about the postal service, is just for the fact that these are something I'm gonna keep in the package. I mean, if you've known me before, I definitely like to open up my toys, or if anything, just display them in display cases and stuff like that. These though, these are gonna be my prized possessions. I don't even know what words to put together other than the fact of this right here. This is my childhood. I had the firehouse. I had the Proton pack. It's so rare that people kept those toys back in the 80s. There's people out there that have the original Ecto-1 car in a box. Conditions pretty darn good. And those things are running like $5,000. For a car that came out in the 1980s. Anytime they do reboots or they, you know, they replicate what was in the past, they aren't worth a damn. But to me, that's where the worth factor is because these are worth more than $5,000 to me. These are worth, this is my love. Look at these things. Last but not least, you've got Ray. I mean, I'm looking at the eyes, the details, there's literally no detail oriented whatsoever. And that's just what the early 90s was in terms of toys. Ah, these things are just gorgeous. This is another one, unfortunately, that's subdued to good old postal service corner here. Shoot, maybe if I'm in a Walmart, I'll actually look to see if they are any on display, and then maybe I can find a better condition one. I'm just excited and blown away on just how awesome. They're bigger than I remember. I think that's another thing too that's kind of shocking. I mean, if you put it up to my head, I don't have a very big head because it's not lots in there, but you know, so it's pretty cool. The beautiful thing too with these figures is I have all the pieces. Those of you that ever had these back in the day, you might have actually had the figure. Like, probably there's still many of you out there that have these figures, but I guarantee you do not have any of the accessories. I guarantee you've lost the ghost. I guarantee you've broken the Proton pack and the photon stream. Guaranteed. This is how it should be. This is how it should have been back when they first came out and I received them, but I was 5. Who knows? I don't know. Who would have thought? If I had a time machine, I'd go back and say, keep them in the package, but otherwise, yeah. Monday, May 4th is officially Star Wars Day. If you don't have Disney Plus, I highly, highly, highly recommend getting Disney Plus. You need to be watching The Clone Wars, the final season, season 7. Ahsoka is experiencing Order 66, and it's just, the story is being beautifully written. If you're not watching a Star Wars movie on Monday, shame on you. You should be, even if it's in the background. So do it. Other than that, thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. Go ahead and follow us everywhere that you can. And thanks just for all the support. I really do appreciate it. Happy Star Wars Day. Take care of yourself. It's Bottom Nerd. We will see you guys later. Bye-bye. Toys that you love, buy them because frankly you deserve it.